And it's first I thought when I told you, well, is this what you mean when you say the only piece, let's say, of identity that you would accept for yourself is not nationality? That's nothing. So all the things that we would somehow put together to get a sort of picture of identity, you ignore. The only piece that you would accept, obviously, is language. But it's not language in that sense that makes the difference between the creation of Serbian reading of Musa's novel. Language as writing
tool, and also language is something, I think I invented my language. And I think that I'm the only one that speaks this Serbian that I speak. And I did it on purpose, and maybe it's not important or beautiful or poetic or whatever, but it's invented language. And this is probably on the other part of my identity. And also I believe I speak some languages, and I live a very complicated life, living in different countries, where I'm obliged. You know, if I sleep talk, I talk in different languages. I live with a Frenchman, we live in Azerbaijan, people over there. Finally, I speak Serbian to the people on the street, because this is a way between Russian and Turkish to find like a middle way. And I realized that in all the languages that I use, so you have to use English, and you know, I learned German, and you just change. I juggle. I have different identities. So when I'm a diplomat's wife, I'm like a very French lady. And when I'm, you know, person who is interested in human rights, then I'm like, you know, Anglo-Saxon, whatever. But all of this is fake. It's not me. Me, the only thing is my identity.
The other way around, so it demands the identity that you could also accept it.
Of course, yes. I think that there is
a way to deny it or to, on the other hand, accept it or even overemphasize it.
I think this is the stupidity, a human stupidity, is to try to search for one identity for itself. And this is what is happening in Europe now. I mean, they keep telling us, like, actually Europe has a Christian white background, which is not true. This is on one of the levels. And even, you know, Europe is a like society, solidar society. It is true, but it's not totally true. We have different levels in everything. Europe is also black, Africans, some with no job and no language to speak. Europe is also people fighting wars. Europe is also people living in inhuman conditions and being abused by their employers. This is also Europe. And I think we have to accept that there are always several identities, and sometimes they are against each other. But we can all live with them in ourselves.
But even though from a personal experience with friends and family and neighbors, that there's a certain and a huge amount of desire to gain or to see some identity for oneself, obviously. And it's not many people who can manage to get along with the fact that there's, if there is any identity, it would be sort of a multiple identity. So there is, as a matter of fact, there is huge desire to gain identity. I even could imagine that you have felt it sometimes.
Yes, of course. I just questioned with myself, what is there that I'm missing? And, you know, in Serbia, very often you are in a situation to be asked, how come that you don't belong? What are you if you're not Serbian? And outside of Serbia, I'm asked the same question. And people insist on that. So you are a Serbian, right? And yes, I am. But this is only one of the things that I am. In France, for example, to have a French name, citizenship, they don't make a difference between nationality and citizenship. So once